It's going to be Delhi Daredevils' first home game. They've played five on the road and finally they come back to the Feroz Shah Kotla, and they're going to be taking on, guess who? The top of the table, Kings 11 Punjab. Northern Derby.
It's a big one for DD, and they've got good record at home, especially against Kings 11 Punjab. I think, you know, they've won a lot of games against Kings 11 playing at home. So they should take confidence from that. Otherwise, it's going to be late for Delhi. I think, you know, for home game, you know, home team advantage, home ground advantage, all the talks have been there, but Delhi wicket has not been that supportive to Delhi over the years. So that's one thing they have to really take note of. And also, the home games, the stretch of home games, they need to start on a winning note. That's very important. I think that can really build the momentum. So they have to make that conscious effort of not looking at the points table, not looking at what other teams are doing, not looking at where Kings 11 is on the points table and how many wins they've had. They got to just focus on themselves and take the inspiration within the group and stack up performances together, because they're going to need not one, I think they're going to need two, three performances.
Ironically, even though they might be coming home and they've had a stretch of wins at times, overall, their record at home is not great.
No, it isn't. But this is a chance to change something. The other thing is that, look, what they will have to do tomorrow, and I think they're in the right mental situation for it, is they have to attack. You know, they have to attack Gayle, they have to attack Rahul, because you cannot contain those players. You have to try and take their wickets.
Today,
and I think,
actually.
Oh, today?
Yes.
It's today now.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to go after them, because the point of it is they are like, you know, they have to play like cornered tigers, that okay, they've got nothing to lose, they're going to go there and they're just going to go after these guys, because it's a small ground, it's not a big ground as well. So if somebody like Gayle gets going, you can't allow it, you can't hope to contain people here.
Strategically, I mean, because they're playing at home, if you have to contain Gayle in this sort of form, since you're in Delhi, playing at home, slip soap in a shower, what can you do to stop Gayle?
Those kind of solutions are there, but no, I wouldn't try it. I mean, long time back, we've heard of food poisoning and all.
Yeah, food poisoning. Take him to Jama Masjid nearby. It's an excellent food, lovely food.
I have to tell you, though, the funniest story about Jama Masjid. Apparently, long time back, the Pakistani cricketers came, and this is the days before the internet, and they were playing in India, and somebody said that the best food is obviously, you know, at Jama Masjid, so you've got to go and eat out there. So they said, how do we go? He said, "Dude, just sneak in there." So they put Wasim Akram and two, three other Pakistani players in a burqa. Okay? Within about 10 minutes, there were 1,000 people outside. So somebody said, "Wasim Akram, 6'3" man in a burqa, what do you expect people to do? Who do you think is going to come and eat there?" It was absolutely crazy. So just like that, I think Gayle also, you can't, trying to hide him in a burqa and giving him food at Jama Masjid is not a good idea.
We started with biryani in the afternoon. We've come to Jama Masjid here. We've got a man who knows all about running a restaurant. So it's become a foodie show towards the end of the day. Brilliant. And the red table
numbers
is still intact,
food,
by the way. It hasn't
numbers
left, by the way, in case at this time of night. GK, if you're still watching, yes,
it's still
been
there.
Laid out. The red table is still there. We've paid respect to it. We've paid homage to it. And it's been a great day. By the way, we haven't forgotten about the joy factor.
Ah, and it's something that is, what they say, is hurting to bowlers. So if you ask a question, we'll have a look at it and I'll give you the answer.
Yes. Okay, we'll look at that in a while. But I think we just want to have one look at the lineups for tomorrow's game. So, former skipper, any changes?
Well, this is how Gautam is going to be when he's looking at the side and looking at, you know, what are the possible changes. I see a possible change, maybe Amit Mishra coming back. You know, maybe if the wicket is supporting spin, they will think of adding one more spinner to the lineup, or maybe think of giving Tivati a break.
Yeah, that's
might
a
be
kind way of saying it, giving him a break, because he's been pretty good otherwise.
Yeah.
Kings 11 Punjab, I don't think you want to tamper with anything there.
I don't want to tamper with anything. I don't think they look at it, but exactly that. I think they need Mishra tomorrow, because if they're going to play Delhi, he knows Delhi conditions as good as anyone else does. He really knows it, though he plays for Haryana. He's played a lot of his cricket in this part of the world. He's played for Delhi very well with distinction. I think he's going to be a factor tomorrow. I don't see much. I mean, they don't need to change around. And I don't think it's a really good idea to change around a winning combination unless you have this thing. Again, looking forward to Mayank Agarwal's performances.
Why did you bring that up suddenly?
See, Mayank Agarwal is, for me, I told you, he's the Cinderella of the IPL. He promises he'll get his 18-20. Just when he's looking good, he'll disappear like Cinderella.
And you had to say that at 12, just
at
after
12 o'clock. Just after 12
o'clock. Yeah, yeah. I mean, he's a good
and
friend.
And I've promised Joy that, you know, next innings he's going to play, which is of decent innings. He's going to be 35 deliveries faced and 50 runs scored.
He's already promised me. Yeah. On Mayank's behalf.